The Golden Gate Bridge is an impressive structure. It's a suspension bridge that has a bunch of cables and somehow manages to stay upright and support the weight of cars driving across it. So how do people design things like that? It starts by having an understanding of the laws of physics that govern what they're making. We're going to dive into that world with understanding Newton's laws of motion. We'll start with forces and then do the first law, the second law, talk about mass and weight, and then get into the third law. We'll end with some comments on how to apply these by drawing free body diagrams and applying Newton's laws to describe motion. Forces are pushes or pulls. They're vector quantities, which means that they have a magnitude and a direction. We represent them as an arrow, that's the direction, and the length of the arrow is proportional to the magnitude. We'll put this arrow over the top to represent that this is a vector quantity. The unit of force is called a newton after Isaac Newton, who came up with Newton's laws, and it's equal to 1 kilogram meter per second squared. So that's the SI unit for force. In standard units, you might see pounds, but we're going to be sticking to SI units here. Forces can come from a number of things. It can come from contact. So you press on something, you feel a force. They can come from field forces. These don't require direct contact. One example of these are gravity. It's a field force. This pen is not touching the Earth, and yet it's feeling a force pulling it towards the Earth. There are some fundamental forces that seem to be the fundamental ones, and then other forces can be expressed as manifestations of these forces. So first we have gravitational. There's electromagnetic, that if you continue to study physics, you'll get a better understanding of how that works. There's strong nuclear and weak nuclear forces that I'm not going to go into now. And these are the fundamental forces. So a question arises, what's a contact force then? We have these contact forces that we're familiar with that's pushing on things, but I'm claiming that that's not one of the fundamental forces. That's just some manifestation of one of these. So what causes it? Spoiler alert. It's electromagnetic, but also the Pauli exclusion principle. Both things I'm not going to go into right now. So thinking about different models of physics, we're going to be going with a model where contact forces are the force we care about, and we're going to treat those as the force, and we're not going to worry about what causes those. I'm not going to explain about the Pauli exclusion principle that keeps things from occupying the same space. I'm not going to tell you about electromagnetism right now. It's fine. This model of dealing with forces is just fine and lets us say a lot of useful things.